island off the Maine coast called Matinicus Rock. We live there because my family had a very important job to do. We had to take care of the lighthouse that stood in the center of the island. You see, Matinicus Rock is far off the Maine coast, and it's the first part of Maine that a sailor would see when he sailed his great schooner toward the coastal town of Rockland. So, in the dark of night, the sailors needed a light to warn them that they were approaching the coast. If they didn't see the glimmer of light from our lighthouse, their ships would be in great danger of running aground on the rocky shoals, shattering their boats before they could arrive safely ashore. Today, I'm going to tell you the story about an adventure I had when I was living with my family on Matinicus Rock. It took place a long time ago during a terrible winter storm called a nor'easter. But don't worry, even though it was scary, it had a happy ending. Now, I'm not going to tell the story all by myself. I'm going to get help from some very special people. I'd like to introduce them to you. Each of them is a musician from the Aurea.
Thank you.
the ocean theme. You know why? Because it sounds like the ocean. My friends will play for you, and let's see if you can hear the gentle rolling of the swells across the deep, peaceful ocean floor.
We're going to hear the noise from you now, so we'll be
gaze those eyes to the sky.
Thank you. Thank you.
winter turned into spring, and spring turned into summer. Summer was my favorite season on the rock. My favorite thing to do was to go down to the rocky ledge and watch the puffins, those silly black and white birds with the orange beaks. There were hundreds of them huddled on the rocks, tending to their young, pecking at each other, squawking about with little toys as they fought for a foothold. Metinicus is famous for its puffins, and even today, people come from miles away to see them do their silly little dances.
Thank you.
Ocean water poured onto the door. Quick, I cried, let's go to the tower. It's stronger. We ran into the tower and held each other tightly as we felt the powerful waves wash over us. Then I knew that the time I had feared had finally come. Soon the nor'easter would be upon our little island. I knew Papa was stuck out in the storm, and even if he wanted to turn back around, the blinding rain, huge waves would make it impossible for him to successfully tie up to our little dock. As nighttime approached, I knew that now it was entirely up to me to do the job that had brought our family to the Tinnitus Rock years ago, to keep the sailors and their ships safe. I swallowed deeply, gathered my courage, and prepared to do what Papa had told me I must. Climb the steep staircase in each tower and light the lamp.
Thank you.
wrenched it open, and began a treacherous climb through the darkness. Up and up I went, holding onto the cold iron railings tightly as I could. But I reached the top and pushed hard against the trapdoor, leading to the lamp room. And I got it open and looked out the windows toward the North Tower. I saw the light.
The first thing I did every morning
was to run to the top of the North Tower and look out into the vast ocean for Papa's tiny boat. He had been gone so long, and I wondered if he had been safe during the Great Nor'easter. Always.